Howdy, it's Bergs, and today I am having my turn to have a look at the fabulous Torpedo C.A.B, or Torpedo C.A.B by Two Notes Audio Engineering from France. It's been around for a while, and it's taken me a while to show it on my channel, and I apologise to the guys at Two Notes, but here we are today having a look at it. So what is it? It's basically a professional speaker simulator that you can put at the end of your pedal board, or at the end of a preamp, or at the end of an effects send from a standard sort of amplifier. Today I'm going to look at it in a couple of different ways. We're going to pair it up with the AMT Stonehead, which is a 50 watt solid state amp, four channels, but I'm not using any of the power amp section of it. I'm just using its preamp, so we're going to use the clean, crunch, and a couple of lead channels. The Torpedo C.A.B ships with about 30 different speakers. It also ships with guitar speakers, 10 bass speakers. It also has different mic emulations. It has power amp emulations. It has a couple of basic reverbs and a fabulous EQ section. It's just really good. So first of all, the clean sound from my AMT without the C.A.B turned on. So I'm going to bypass it. Not so good, huh? Much better. Now that's a JC120 cabinet. Which is fantastic for clean sounds. I can go up a preset here, and I've got a Berg EVH, or an Eddie C.A.B, which is like a 5150 C.A.B. A distinctly different sound. And I've got a Cathedral reverb on it, and it's going to work fabulously if I hit something like the crunch channel. Now, if I bypass that again, you'll hear what it sounds like without it. Like crap. So we'll turn it back on. Now if I go up another setting to my Blues Deluxe, a much smaller cabinet, so it's got a tighter sound. Same sound coming from the preamp, different speaker simulation, back to the Eddy, and then back to the JC120, also with the crunch channel from the AMT. So you can see how much difference just the speaker makes to your preamp sound. Let's go back to the Eddy preset, and we're going to go into edit mode. There are two types of edit mode: simulation, which is kind of comprehensive and all-encompassing, and also arcade. I'm going to use simulation so we can see what it'll do. It's just a matter of hitting the parameter knob here. The power amp is on. That's good. I want to leave it on. The model is a push-pull EL34, so I can change that if I want to. To an 84 or a KT88, and you can hear the difference that those power amp tubes make, which is quite significant. Then we've got volume of the power amp. I've got it at 30 dB, which is pretty pumping, and I'm going to leave it there. Presence of the power amp, depth of the power amp, pentode or triode. Pentode has more headroom. I'm definitely a pentode guy. Miking is on, and the mic that we have chosen, there's the cabinet. If I don't want to use the Eddy cabinet, I can just choose it to anything else, a California Standard. There's a million of them. I've got quite a few loaded in, as well as the 30 that it ships with. Sorry that I'm talking so fast. There's a lot to get through here. The mic that I'm using is a Ribbon 160. But I can change it to like a Royal 121, which is a slightly softer sound. And then if I move across, I can move the center position of it. A away from the center of the speaker or towards the center of the speaker. And also front position or back position, we'll keep it at the front. The EQ is on. For guitar, you can choose guitar or bass. If you're using a bass simulation, we're using guitar, so we'll stick with guitar. I've got it at 6 dB at 120 Hz, which is quite high. If I want to roll that bottom end off, I can just roll it off like so, and then we move across the frequency range 360, 800, 2 kHz, and I've got 6 dB boost at 6 kHz, which is quite high, so I'll roll it back to 3, and I might just boost up 2. Not bad, getting close. I could still work on it a little bit though. Then we've got reverb, which is on. I can turn it off, we'll leave it on. And then you've got the type of reverb, which I've chosen to be cathedral. And then you've got a wet and dry mix. Now, if I'm happy with all of that, all I've got to do is hold it to save it and save it again, and yep, there it is, done saving, all good. Now, the great thing about the Torpedo Cab is, well, one, it sounds amazing. Two, you can use it with a preamp like the AMT Stonehead, or you can use it with just a standard pedal board. And today I have another pedal that's made in France. This one by Buffalo Effects. It's a TDX. It's basically a tube driver clone. I am now going to stop this video and plug this pedal directly into the Torpedo Cab so we can have a listen to what it sounds like just with a standard overdrive slash distortion pedal. Okay, so I'm back and I now have my TDX plugged directly into the Torpedo Cab. So this is a kind of a simulation of what you could do with your pedal board if you wanted to use a speaker simulator, this speaker simulator, after your pedal board to feed directly to the desk. So here it is, straight to the Blues Deluxe amp that I dialed up earlier. Then we put our tube driver in front of it. Let's go to the Eddy amp. Now this is where you're going to have to get clever and actually program some sounds to suit pedals kind of versus a preamp. So that to me sounds a little bit dull. I'm going to go in here and across to the parameters, and I'm going to actually tune the Eddy amp to be a little bit more present. The ribbon 121, I'm going to choose a 57 instead. Let's keep moving across. Position front EQ on, yes, 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 that looks good, that looks good. 2 kHz, maybe a bit more presence in the upper end, so I'm just going to boost that 6 kHz. Good. How's it sound with the JC amp? Let's have a look. Completely different again. So the amount of scope that it gives you if you're using it with a pedal board is vast. You can choose a Marshall cab, you can choose an Engel cab, you can choose a rectifier cab or a Roland cab, like so. Very, very vast. Now, I just want to show you the software that you can download for free, the Torpedo Remote, because it's important as well. Mm-hmm. This is the Torpedo remote software, and as you can see, it gives us a basic visual representation of everything that's going on inside the Torpedo cab itself. So if you're working in a studio or you just want something to look at while you're editing, this is the go. As you can see, we've got our Eddy cab here. We've got our microphone that is lined up right in the middle of the speaker, but we can move it anywhere in the field that we wish. So we can move it off center if we want to. If we want to change to say 57, we can do that here. And the 57 has that more nasally quality. We can bang it right in the middle of the speaker. Then we can wind down our EQ slot here, or our EQ strip, however you'd like to call it. I might shave a little bottom end off and drop that 6 kilohertz a little bit. Over here in our power amp section, we've got a push-pull. That's what PP stands for. PPEL34. I can change that to, say, a push-pull EL84, which will give it a slightly different sound, or I can make it into a, turn it into a single-ended EL34. I think it's probably better off where it was, which was the push-pull EL34. Yes, I can choose between pentode or triode. Triode is thicker sounding, but it's less headroom. I kind of go for the pentode. I'm a pentode sort of a guy. I can also use these knobs down here to alter the microphone position. Same with choosing front or back. And I can also choose the room in which our cabinet is situated. So if I don't like the cathedral, I can choose any one of these different rooms, let's say a loft. And I get a lovely picture of a loft, and then I can move the microphone accordingly to wherever I want it. So that's basically the Two Notes remote software, which is very valuable. They also do another software called, if I'm not mistaken, Blend IR, which lets you create your own impulse responses. That's what IR stands for, which means you can model your own cabinet from your own studio. I haven't got around to doing that yet, but I hope to sometime. In the meantime, this remote is going to help me infinitely when I'm running on Logical Pro Tools or whatever I choose to be using, and also deciding on which cab, because down here we've got the guitar cabinet menu, so if I didn't like the Eddy cab and I wanted to use something like, I don't know, a British thing, here we go. So that, my friends, is the Torpedo remote software, or the Torpedo cab software that runs the Torpedo cab, which is an infinitely fantastic device, good for keyboards, bass, guitar, anything you want to stick into it, really, to give you an amplifier simulation or anywhere where you need kind of silent treatment on your instrument. Thanks for watching. It's Brett Kingman signing off for Two Notes. See you soon.